stop that is clutched. It's fast now.
Freeman, long shot is put up by Leighton.
It's out! It's out! It's out! It's out! Leighton! Leighton, it's out!
Y'all ready for this?
Well, you said it, Willie. That the game has just swung from side to side to side. And hey, Leighton got a good look at it right at the mid-court line. Unbelievable finish.
Inbounds pass, Freeman to Leighton, directly in front of the 10-second line here at the auditorium. He let it fly, nothing but net.
Hi, I'm Jeannie Miller, a cheerleader at Marble High School, and welcome to Channel 5 sports coverage of Class A high school basketball. Let's go, Cougars!
Live from Brewer High School, it's the Cougars of Mount Blue versus the Witches of Brewer.
Tournament last year, it came down to that Jason Leighton heave to win the game. It was a life and death shot for Jason Leighton, and this time it's a life and death game for the Brewer Witches. Brewer needs this game oh so desperately, and they need a little help to make the Eastern Maine Basketball Tournament. The latest standings show Messalonsky on top, but look down at the bottom. Mount Blue is number 6, and Brewer is in 11th if they beat the 6th-ranked team tonight. And they get a little help from Lawrence beating Coney. They could move into that 8th spot. They could have enough points. This is so important, and Tom Winston, obviously, if you're going to get geared up for any game, it's going to be a game like this just to make it to the tournament.
I tell you, Tim, if they don't get keyed up for tonight's game, they're never going to get keyed up for a game, and they certainly don't deserve to be in the tournament if they aren't keyed up. The key thing, as I see it tonight, Brewer reminds me of a cat with 9 lives. It looks like they've been down and out a number of times, and here they're playing their final game at home in front of a huge crowd on TV with a chance to go to the tournament. Should be a good ball game.
Yeah, it can't be much more fun to be a spectator in a game like this, Mike Hale. Mount Blue coming in here with something to prove as well. They can move up in the standing.
Yeah, they could pick up a notch tonight. They come into this game with 3 players back from last year, starting in that exciting game from the tournament last year. Ryan Fortier's back, 28 points the last time they played. And they also picked up 2 transfer students, Jeremy Bryant from Jay, Troy Wilkins from Mount Abram. So they filled those 2 slots they lost in graduation very nicely. Jim Bessie's Cougars in a good place right now. They're in the middle of the pack. They're the kind of team that could sneak from the middle to win the tournament.
We'll be back in just a moment to see what the coaches think about this final game of the regular season right after this.
Channel 5 sports coverage of high school basketball is brought to you by your New England Jeep and Eagle dealers.
Just rolling out of bed, do not look outside.
The new Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo offers an available V8 and full-time four-wheel drive.
On the way, buses are running behind.
Anti-lock disc brakes and dual airbags.
Getting through.
Plus a lease rate of just $369 a month with no money down.
It's a great day for snowmen.
Making the new Jeep Grand Cherokee greatly underappreciated by school kids everywhere.
See your New England Jeep and Eagle dealers.
Who's calling? Could it be the realtor? Hey, maybe she's got somebody interested in the house. Ooh, maybe she's got an offer.
Hello?
If you missed the call, press *69. 9X will return the call for you.
They want to see the house? Great. In an hour?
When you're not in time, *69. It's on your phone right now. Another way 9X makes your life simpler.
It's Front Row, sounds easy, and Home Vision Videos, everything's on sale. This Saturday, starting at 9 a.m., there are so many new releases coming in March, we don't know where we're going to put them. So here's your chance to build your library and save big. Hot new releases, video games, kid vids, everything. Everything on our rental shelves is on sale. We've got to make room for the new releases coming in March. That means you get the savings during the Everything's on Sale at all Front Row, Sounds Easy, and Home Vision Video stores. Saturday, starting at 9 a.m.
Back on the floor with the coaches, and first of all, Mark Savage, you can't be telling kids any more than you got to have this one to make it a big event.
Well, we're trying to tell them we win, we're in. We're hoping that's true. It's do or die for us.
You need some help, I think, from Lawrence, too, to beat Coney. We'll let you know that score as soon as we get it in, Mark, make you feel a little better. But this, can you feel good about a game like this, playing against a Mount Blue team that's already there?
Yeah, I mean, this is tournament atmosphere. I think you'll feel that here in our gym tonight. I think you'll see it in our kids tonight. And, you know, Mount Blue is going to come out and play hard, and hopefully we'll do the same.
Keep him loose tonight, Mark.
Okay.
Mark Savage. Jim Bessie, Jim, you're coming in, you don't know where you're going to be in the tournament. Are you playing with as much motivation as a Brewer team?
Well, I mean, I think anytime you lace up the sneakers, you're going to play with motivation. Obviously, there's a lot more pressure on them to win this game because we're already in the tournament and they're trying to seek their way in.
You're also trying to avoid playing in that that 8 a.m. matchup. That would be nice.
Well, that would be very nice. Yeah, 8 o'clock in the morning is pretty early.
Good luck tonight, Jim.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Jim Bessie of the Mount Blue Cougars, and last time these two teams met, Mount Blue wins by 1 point. We should have a good one. Now let's go upstairs. Mike.
Thank you, Tim. And in that game where Mount Blue won the game in Farmington, Ryan Fortier, a big game, had 28 points as the Cougars held off Brewer. Troy Wilkins, 13 points. For Brewer, Jason Leighton had 17 points as Brewer put four players in double figures. Troy Levitt had 13, Nate Freeman 12, and Adam King 10 for the Witches. And that game was close all the way. Mount Blue led 14-6 at the end of one, 25-19 at halftime. At the end of three, it was a four-point lead for Mount Blue, 42-38, and then at the end it was 67-64, Mount Blue. So going back to the tournament last year, Tom Winston and the first game of the season when they met earlier in the season, these two teams certainly have had some memorable battles.
Oh, certainly have. Two competitive coaches, two very competitive programs. Both teams doing very well in the last few years here in Eastern Maine Class A boys basketball. I had a chance, Mike, to talk to Mark Savage just a few minutes ago, and he said the one key, more than any other key tonight, is turnovers. We've got to take care of the ball. We did not do that in Farmington earlier in the year, and we've got to do that tonight. Priority number one, take care of the ball.
Brewer, probably their biggest problem this year has been inconsistencies. They've played during the year, like we saw a couple of weeks ago, beating Bangor at the auditorium, like a team that was number one themselves, and then they've had games where they should have won that they struggled in. So they've had a really hard time to find their niche this season.
I tell you what, they certainly have been a mystery in many ways. They can play with the best of teams, and then they've played down sometimes to their competition. But I tell you what, if I were the number one, two team in the tournament, I certainly would not want to play a team like Brewer should they make it into the tournament.
Well, as Bangor learned, this team can certainly turn it on when they have to. We're going to take a break. We'll be back at Brewer High School in a moment.
Guys are persistent.
Well, they're no match for the world's first sport utility wagon.
Oh, really?
All-wheel drive Subaru Outback's got the ground clearance of an Explorer.
Uh-huh.
More headroom than a Cherokee. And ride smooth as any car.
Got any more of those tidbits?
What, like more stability in a turn than a Chevy Blazer?
That'll do.
That's my Subaru Outback.
Village Subaru, 295 Hogan Road, Bangor.
Well, the Class A basketball season will be wrapping up at the end of this week, and then the points will be tallied, and we'll find out who finishes where when we kick off the tournament a week from Saturday at the Bangor Auditorium. So another sign of spring.
I tell you, a lot of nervous coaches around tonight. Let's go down to the floor, and PA announcer Dennis Kaya.
At this time, the athletic department would like to publicly thank the band for your support throughout the season, not just in basketball, but in the hockey games. We know that tonight wasn't on your tour, but thanks for coming out for this special event. As a member of the Big East Basketball Conference, we ask for your cooperation in displaying proper sportsmanship. We expect that as spectators, you will encourage and support all of the participants in this contest and will not contribute to any negative behavior. Thank you for your support of sportsmanship and Big East Athletics. Now I'd like to introduce to you team members for the visiting Mount Blue Cougars. Number 12, Kevin Egers. Number 13, Matt Duffy. Number 14, Nate Franson. Number 15, Eric Miskin. Number 24, Scott Myrick. Number 25, Mirza Uzanvich. And number 31, Joe McLaughlin. And now for the home team, Brewer Witches. Number 12, Aaron Lage. Number 24, Chris Corson. Number 30, Eric Duffy. Number 32, Rob Pawson. Number 34, John Bennett. Number 40, Danny Coffin. Number 42, Marco Kamezic. Number 50, James Hinckley. And number 54, Buddy Chambers. And now for the starting lineups. For Mount Blue, number 20, Ryan Fortier. And for Brewer, number 10, Nate Freeman. For Mount Blue, number 21, Jim Ross. And for Brewer, number 14, Adam King. For Mount Blue, number 22, Dustin Ireland. And for Brewer, number 20, Troy Lovett. For Mount Blue, number 23, Jeremy Bryant. And for Brewer, number 22, Jason Leighton. For Mount Blue, number 30, Troy Wilkins. For Brewer, number 52, Mike Johnston. The Cougars are coached by Jim Bessie, assisted by Chris Brinkman, Ollie Faulkner, and Gene McCabe. The Witches are coached by Mark Savage, assisted by Becky Boober, Harold Williams, and Ron Brown. The officials for tonight's game are Mr. Harmon and Mr. Shoppie. And now would you all stand as we honor our country with the playing of our national anthem by the band of Brewer High School under the direction of Jerusha Reynolds.
It's a tournament atmosphere here tonight at Brewer High School as Mount Blue and the Brewer Witches get ready to wrap up their regular season tonight. A must win for Brewer.
We're not in Kansas anymore.
Toto.
This is a ball game. It's a fun. The crowd, the atmosphere, not many seats to be had here in the Brewer High School gym on either side. A good crowd here, Mike, from Mount Blue.
It's warm in the gym tonight. It's crowded and it's noisy and it has all the makings of a classic basketball game. Brewer Witches currently number 11 at 8-9. Mount Blue Cougars number 6 at 12-5. Adam King at 6'5", jumping center for Brewer in the white. And Troy Wilkins, 6'6", junior center for Mount Blue. And the tap comes away to the Cougars to start this one.
Man-to-man defense by the Brewer Witches to open the ball game.
Ryan Fortier brings it back out on top to Jeremy Bryant. In the post, Troy Wilkins. He'll bring it back out front. It will be good for three. If it goes, it comes up short for Jim Ross and a Brewer rebound. Adam King brings it up for the Witches. Brewer in the white, Mount Blue in the blue uniforms. Troy Levitt pops it in the paint for two, and Brewer will take the lead in this one, 2-0.
Good job that time of getting it inside. Levitt converts on the two from the paint.
In the paint, Troy Wilkins will fire it a little bit too high. The rebound is pulled down by Mike Johnston of Brewer. They'll try to break away now. They do get the layup off the glass by Troy Levitt, and Brewer leads 4-0.
Notice that time how Levitt protected the basketball using his body.
From the foul line, the shot is up and in by Jeremy Bryant. And it's real interesting. Jeremy Bryant and Troy Wilkins, two transfer students. Bryant from Jay. Troy Wilkins from Mount Abram. That's a coach's dream.
Get that right. Quality basketball players.
Now Wilkins transfers over at 6'6". Brewer will go down low. Shot won't go for Johnston on the baseline. It's going to be pulled down by Dustin Ireland of Mount Blue. It's Jim Ross with the ball for the Mount Blue Cougars. Nearly stolen away by Nate Freeman. Pass underneath from Jim Ross to Troy Wilkins, and Wilkins scores the layup to tie this game at 4 with 6 minutes to go in the first.
Both teams like to go up and down the floor here. Mount Blue probably even a little more than Brewer.
Mike Johnston in the paint gets the bounce, and Brewer's on top 6-4.
Well, I've said this a few times this year. Mike Johnston has been their key this year, the stabilizing influence that really has given Brewer a chance.
Mount Blue breaks the Brewer press. Going to the hoop, Ryan Fortier, the leading scorer on this team. Ryan Fortier, number 20, had 28 points the first time they played Brewer this year. So he can explode. Adam King tries to go baseline, brings it back out to Troy Levitt. Levitt fires it up a bit short. And on the rebound, it will be tapped out of bounds by Nate Freeman. It's Mount Blue ball.
Mount Blue 8-2 in their last 10 ball games, starting off 4-3, currently 12-5.
Got a travel in the backcourt on Jeremy Bryant, and the Cougars will turn it over. Nice crowd on hand here at Brewer High tonight. 5:24 to go in the first. Leighton out front. It's good for two as 1 foot was on the circle out front. But Troy Levitt puts Brewer on top 8-6. And here we go the other way. Ryan Fortier to the hoop, ties it at 8. Tied at 8 with 5 minutes to go in the first. There is a pretty shot up and in by number 14, Adam King.
Boy, if he gets off early, watch out, because he gets some confidence, he's going to be tough.
On the baseline, a strong move to the basket, Ryan Fortier. And we're tied at 10 in a fast-paced first period. Down low, Johnston on the post, spins, he won't get it. Rebounds pulled down by Dustin Ireland of Mount Blue. That is brought up by Jim Ross. The pass in the paint is loose, but picked up by Fortier. He'll miss the shot, and a foul on the rebound. Be on number 30, Troy Wilkins. And that's the first foul of the game. Wilkins crashing over the back with 4:21 to go in the first. We're tied at 10.
Mr. Harmon and Mr. Sharpie handling this one as far as the officiating crew.
King fires a three-pointer and misses. A rebound pulled down by Troy Wilkins. And Jim Ross quickly in the front court goes down low to Ryan Fortier on the baseline. Up and in, Adam King had a hand on it, and Fortier still managed to get it off the glass and in. Mount Blue leads 12-10 with just under 4 minutes to go in the first. Down low, Johnston. He just muscled his way in for that basket.
Great position, got him that 2 points.
Tied at 12. The other way, Ryan Fortier, who averages over 17 points a game, takes it strong to the hoop for Mount Blue. Both teams attacking the basket quickly early. Not hesitating to put the shot in the air. Most of them are really high percentage shots, and Brewer's been hitting outside. Leighton at the foul line comes up short. Johnston chases down the rebound. Gives it off to Nate Freeman, and a foul will be called on Jeremy Bryant for Mount Blue, number 23.
One of the things, Mike, that Mark Savage said before the game is we have got to control Ryan Fortier. You're not going to stop a player of his capability, but you've got to control him. And so far, he's done a pretty good job.
Joe McLaughlin has checked in the game for Mount Blue, 6'4 junior. Also, Eric Miskin, a 6-foot junior, is in for Mount Blue as well. Here is a long one from Adam King that's way off. Here comes Mount Blue. It's Jeremy Bryant with a strong move to the hoop. And now it's 16-12, Mount Blue by four. Fade away on the baseline, won't go for Leighton, and Brewer will only get one shot. Ryan Fortier brings it out front, throws it into the backcourt to Jeremy Bryant for the violation, and Brewer will have it at midcourt. On the far side. And as often is the case for Mark Savage, he brings five fresh new players in the game just to see if I did my homework. James Hinckley checks in. Also, John Bennett is in the game. Let me see. Rob Pawson is in. Buddy Chambers. And number 24, Chris Corson. Five brand new bodies for the Brewer Witches. With 2:42 to go in the first, it's a four-point lead for Mount Blue. Brewer being very patient right now. And it's nearly stolen. It's saved inbounds by Dustin Ireland, and Mount Blue gets the basketball. On the baseline, the shot won't go, but the foul on Brewer will be on John Bennett. And that will send Ryan Fortier to the line to shoot two.
Definitely a hack inside as Fortier gets the ball on the block, and he's fouled without question, a hard foul, but he's going to go to the line and have to earn them. He cannot be allowed to get the position on the block that easily. If he catches the ball that easily, it's going to be a long night for Brewer.
Foul shot by Fortier is good. That was the first foul on Bennett. Ryan Fortier, just a solid player, both ends of the floor, good foul shooter, good down low, good outside shooter, leading the Mount Blue Cougars to a 18-12 lead with 2 minutes to go. We're in the first period. And we have a Mount Blue foul. Looks like number 31, possibly. That would be Joe McLaughlin. It is Joe McLaughlin. Be his first, team's third. Brewer has committed only one team foul here in the first period. Inbounds, it comes to Hinckley. He'll give it off to Pawson. Off to Bennett. Bennett on the baseline. Brings it back out to Hinckley. Quickly to Pawson. These are five bench players, and they do a great job giving the five starters a rest, and they control the basketball. Their job is to take only a real good shot.
Good role players, the five that are in there now, really provide some key rest time.
Hinckley has it blocked, tapped up again. Hinckley, nice follow.
That was a
pretty shot.
What a great job of keeping it alive by James Hinckley, and he was rewarded for that with that easy basket.
Dustin Ireland made the nice block for Mount Blue, but Hinckley stayed with it. Four-point lead for Mount Blue. Shot on the baseline, won't go, but a foul on Bennett of Brewer, his second very quickly.
Just a nice job of following your own shot by Hinckley. He gets it, taps it, then gets it again underneath, and he lays it up this time off the glass. So perseverance paid off for James Hinckley.
And Dustin Ireland will go to the foul line, 6-foot junior. Not a big scorer, but does other things for the Mount Blue Cougars. He'll be back next year. Mount Blue showing us some good foul shooting here early on as we see Coach Jim Bessie of the Mount Blue Cougars standing in front of his bench. Minute 10 to go in the first. Second foul shot spins out of there for Ireland. It's a 19-14 lead for Mount Blue. Here comes Brewer with a minute to go in the first. Rob Pawson out front. Off to Buddy Chambers and a travel on Brewer. Chambers, 54, took a step.
Well, we talked earlier, Mike, Brewer's got to take care of the basketball and can't afford turnovers like they just had.
Troy Wilkins back in the game for Mount Blue. Get some more size underneath for the Cougars. And it's stolen away by Brewer and stolen, maybe stolen back by Mount Blue. It's tied up. And the arrow.
Brewer basketball.
Give it to Brewer. As you see, time running down near the end of the first period. It's 19-14, Mount Blue. And Dustin Ireland, who checked out briefly, is back in for Mount Blue.
Pace of the game has changed a little bit in the last 2 minutes. All kinds of offense. When Coach Savage substituted 5-on-5, it was 16-12, and now it's 19-14.
Well, the backup squad, their job is to be a little more patient. It does change the tempo of the game. Chris Corson gets it down low. Hinkley on the baseline. He goes to the hoop, draws the foul, and that will be against number 15, Eric Miskin of Mount Blue, his first. Team's four.
Good job by Hinkley, recognizing that the defender went for the steal, couldn't get it. He went in and got fouled.
James Hinkley, a 6'5 junior, going to the line to shoot two with 19 seconds to go in the first. And against Bangor, Brewer showed the good foul shooting team they can be. And there is getting the bounce off the back of the rim.
I thought you would jinx him, Mike, but he knocked it down for it.
That cuts the lead to three now. Mount Blue 19, Brewer 16. Oh, it's nearly stolen away, knocked out of bounds by Bennett. And Mount Blue will have the basketball with 13 seconds to go in the first period. They lead by three. So far, the kind of game we expected. Fun game. Jim Ross. Off to Miskin. Miskin pulls up on the baseline, comes up short. Rebound underneath Dustin Ireland, but then a foul will be called against Brewer.
Looks like that foul is going to be on Rob Pawson.
Indeed it is. Pawson, the junior, picks up the personal. That's only his first. That'll be the third on Brewer. Not a shooting foul. So with 3 seconds, Mount Blue will try to get a shot off. However, Eric Miskin broke to the basket before the pass got there, and it went out of bounds right into the Brewer bench.
Not only is there a turnover, but no time off the clock there.
That's right. It went from one out of bounds location to the other. Will Brewer get a shot off? They do, but it won't go for Rob Pawson. And that's the end of the first. 19-16, Mount Blue leads Brewer. We're back with the second period in just a moment.
When the high school basketball season comes to an end and things get back to normal, there will probably be a lot of work to catch up on, like that special building project you've been trying to get to. Well, the people at Hammond Lumber Company are ready to work with you to make sure you have all the tools and materials you'll ever need, plus free estimating and free delivery, too. So when you're ready to start building your building team, talk with the people at Hammond Lumber.
Mount Blue with the 3-point lead at the end of the first. Mark Savage ready for second period action as he stands up at the Brewer bench. Brewer out on the floor. Now here comes Mount Blue as we get a look at the Brewer band keeping the fans entertained between periods tonight.
That original starting five back on the floor for Mark Savage and the Brewer Witches.
Well, he put his second string in with about 3 minutes to go in the first. They did a great job. Maintained closeness with Mount Blue.
Actually gained a point in the lead.
And there's a nice move, Ryan. Fortier just strong to the basket. He'll do that all night if you don't keep a hand in his face.
Again, we mentioned it. This is the second or third time, but you can't allow Ryan Fortier to catch the ball that easily in the middle of the lane.
Brewer had a problem defending him in the first game when he had 28 points. And as Leighton drives to the basket, he'll be fouled by number 21, Jim Ross. Well, now they say it's number 30, Troy Wilkins, I think. And that will be one on Wilkins. It's number five on Mount Blue as a team. Neither team in the 1-1 yet. With 7:35 to go in the first half, Mount Blue leads 21-16. Troy Leighton on the line. Excellent foul shooter. He had some big foul shots in that win over Bangor a couple of weeks ago. Of course, he's the young man who made that shot we've been talking about for a long time now last year in that quarterfinal win over Mount Blue from way in the backcourt. When then he was smothered by fans and players. We didn't see him for a while, but he was celebrating underneath there. So both foul shots good for Troy Leighton. Brewer will steal the basketball. Baseline, the shot is up and in by Mike Johnston. And Brewer has cut the lead to one. And they put on some pressure in the backcourt again. It's broken by Jim Ross. And it's stolen away underneath by
Troy Leavitt.
That was Troy Leavitt. Okay. Number 20.
I tell you, what a great play by Troy Leavitt, too. Great move this time. Last time down offensively, Johnston pulls up, hits the short jump shot from the baseline, pulling Brewer to within one. But a great job the last time down on the steal by Leavitt. He got the dribble down, was able to get it on the steal.
There's the touchdown pass down underneath. Jeremy Bryant will make the layup, and it wasn't an easy one. That was a long pass. Shot is missed by Nate Freeman. Rebound Mount Blue, but it's stolen away by Jason Leighton. Takes it into the paint, and on the way to the basket, he was fouled. See, I think it was Dustin Ireland, number 22. That'll be the 16th foul on Mount Blue. That's number one on Ireland. Not a shooting foul, as Leighton was on his way to the hoop at the time. So Brewer will set it up with 6:40 to go in the first half, down by three. Adam King brings it out front to Nate Freeman. Back door, nice move, and the basket for Troy Leavitt.
Boy, great job of catching the defense asleep there. Just made a backdoor cut and got the easy two.
The lead cut to one again, but meanwhile, the other way, two on two. It's Dustin Ireland strong to the basket. 6 foot junior drops it over the front of the rim. It's back up to a 3-point lead for Mount Blue, 25-22. Got 6:10 to go first half. Leighton is called for the offensive foul, the charge. Number 22, Leighton with the foul. Yeah, that's Jason's first, number four on Brewer.
Must have felt he leaned in a little bit to start that drive, creating the contact.
Brewer continues the pressure. This time Mount Blue won't get the long pass, and it will be stolen by Adam King. King caught it in the front court, sailed into the back court. So Mount Blue gets it back.
Actually, a good call there. Really, he head ball in the forecourt and stepped into the backcourt, even though his momentum, all three things, the ball and his feet, were in the backcourt.
That's right. Down the middle. We had a foul before the shot, and it was away from the shot, and that's on Troy Wilkins pushing off underneath. Down low. Cutting underneath is Jason Leighton with a reverse layup. A one-point game. Mount Blue 25, Brewer 24 with 5:35 to go in the first half. And a charge is going to be called on Ryan Fortier, number 20.
Play a nice backdoor cut here, and Brewer's got this down a couple of times. Leighton lays it up, and he went down hard, no foul called. And plays like Troy Leavitt just made, taking that player control foul, are things that can get an offense going.
Fortier with the foul. His first. Brewer trailing Mount Blue by just a point. Down low is Johnston. Mike Johnston.
It's the first lead Mike that Brewer's had for a long time.
Brewer led 2-0. Now they lead 26-25. There's a pretty block. Leighton on the breakaway layup. He's got it, and Brewer leads 28-25. 5 minutes to go, first half. Jeremy Bryant to the basket, and a foul on Brewer.
Troy Levitt tried to step in and take another play, a control foul.
This time it was on him. And that's Troy's first. That's number five on Brewer. And Jeremy Bryant on the foul line for Mount Blue.
Denny Harmon, the official that time, waiting to see if the hoop went in. If it had gone in, I really believe he probably wouldn't have called that foul. He would have let it go. Where it didn't go in, he had to make the call.
Bryant, a 70% free throw shooter, makes one out of two. And Brewer leads 28-26, 4:50 to go first half. King and Leighton out front. Now the ball goes over to Freeman. Cross court, Leighton. Quick pass, Levitt. Down low, Johnston. And a foul before Johnston could go anywhere. Right now, let's get out on the floor to Tim Throckmorton.
Actually up in the stands, Mike, but this is big news for Brewer. Lawrence has beaten Coney, 69-54 the final. And, of course, Brewer needed that to happen to have a chance at making it into the tournament. And, of course, now all Brewer has to do is beat Mount Blue. Mike?
That's all, Tim. And they got their hands full, but they have the lead right now. The foul shot is missed by Johnston. And what do we got, another foul? Looks like it. This one will go against Brewer, and it's on Adam King. Tim Throckmorton supposed to be down on the floor working, sitting up in the stands, watching the game.
The life of a sportscaster, right?
But he's been working hard with the tournament. Nearly stolen away and saved inbounds by King, but it's still Mount Blue ball right in front of the Mount Blue bench, as a matter of fact. 4:33 to go first half. It's Brewer 28, Mount Blue 26. And Jeremy Bryant gives it off to Eric Miskin. Miskin looking down low, runs into a double team, brings it out front to Fortier. Down underneath to the big guy. It won't fall for Troy Wilkins. And on the rebound, a foul. Be a foul on Brewer.
If it is, it's going to put Mount Blue in the bonus situation for the first time.
Both teams shooting 1-1 for the next 4:17 of this half. Foul on Mike Johnston, his first. Team seventh. And Dustin Ireland will go to the line for Mount Blue. Shooting 1-1. And he misses the shot. The rebound, some nice blocking out. Be picked up by Adam King. Now he's in trouble as it's scooped away underneath on the floor. And then it'll be thrown out of bounds by Brewer as Levitt was on his back trying to find somebody in white to give it to.
Also, an interesting attempt that time by Freeman to call a timeout as the ball was going out of bounds. Heads-up play, really, if he could have gotten away with it.
Mount Blue underneath their own basket. Way out front to Miskin, who gives it off to Fortier. And now it's Bryant, stolen away by Brewer. Johnston and Freeman in on the steal, and Adam King brings it up. 3:55 to go in the first half, and a traveling violation on Brewer. By the way, if you're tuning in right now to watch Terrors of the Deep here on Channel 5, which is supposed to be on right now, Terrors of the Deep. It will be shown Monday night at 7. Boy, we could go with that, couldn't we? Seems like all these titles fit in with our broadcast, our telecast. Underneath, pass goes down low. Troy Wilkins at 6'6", drops it over the front of the rim. Tied up at 28. Leighton. Leighton on the baseline. Strong to the basket. It's blocked from behind. It's knocked out of bounds. It's Brewer ball.
I tell you, Leighton couldn't convert on the bunny, but he made a great hesitation dribble outside, give himself a chance just to get to that shot.
He had two Mount Blue Cougars right on his heels. Into Johnston underneath, and he'll put it up and in. He's having a good game. Mike Johnston puts Brewer on top by a basket. 3:25 to go in the first half, and a bump foul at midcourt on Brewer against Nate Freeman. And Mark Savage showing what he thinks about that.
I think he just lost another hair on that.
Savage was complaining about the TV lights during the pregame interview about it causing a reflection off the top of his head, drawing attention to it unnecessarily. So there, one little camera shot on Mark Savage, and we picked on him a bit much there. The foul on Nate Freeman was his first, eighth on the team, as Jeremy Bryant made the first foul shot. Bryant's second one is no good. The rebound won't drop for Ireland. And on the rebound for Brewer, it's Troy Levitt. Off to Leighton, up court to Johnston. And a smart move. He stops, slows it down because he had two defenders between him and the basket.
Good heads-up play by Johnston.
Levitt's hard pass off the hands of Freeman, but it was saved back in the front court by King. And then the foul on Jim Ross in Mount Blue.
I tell you, I like what the officials are doing with this ball game too. They're keeping it closely called. And I think in a game of this importance, you've got to do that because you don't want either team to get out of hand. So far, a pretty good job being done by the officials. I don't know if Jim Bessie would agree with that particular assessment of mine, but I think that they're trying to keep this close, and both teams have a chance to decide this one.
Nate Freeman, a good foul shooter, shooting one and one, makes it. And Brewer leads 31-29. Emotions are high. Brewer needs this game badly. It's an electric atmosphere for both teams.
Freeman, a good foul shooter in the year at 82%, knocks down the second one also.
And Brewers up by three with 3 minutes to go in the half. Brewers had some pretty good pressure tonight, and Mount Blue will throw it out of bounds. Joe McLaughlin in off the bench, thought he had someone open in the front court, threw it over the head out of bounds. Guy would have had to been 12 feet tall to catch that one. 2:45 to go in the half. Brewer by three. They have the basketball. It's Freeman. Tries to get it to Levitt. Bounces off our microphone on the backboard. And Mount Blue comes up with it. This one will be for three. It's good for Jim Ross. And it ties it at 32. Brewer, some pressure in the backcourt. Leighton dragged his pivot foot, takes the step, and travels.
Ross set up on the right-hand side that time for Mount Blue, and he drained the long three-pointer from the baseline. Not in the game at 32.
From the foul line, it won't go for Fortier. The rebound is up and no good by Bryant. And the ball still in the hands of Mount Blue, Jim Ross. And now the shot from the baseline is missed by Dustin Ireland, and we have a pushing foul underneath on the rebound. That'll go against Ryan Fortier of Mount Blue. Jim Bessie on the bench shaking his head saying, I don't think so.
I don't think Ryan Fortier thought a lot of the call either, but you know, they're calling it tight, and the players have to recognize that and adjust to that style that the officiating crew is doing.
And five new players in the game again. 2:14 mark. Coach Savage puts in five fresh players. That's worked very well for them at times this season.
Last time they did this in the first quarter, they were down four when they brought the first crew in at the end of the second, or at the start of the second period. They were only down three, so they actually gained a point.
Actually, it's four new players in the because Troy Levitt has to shoot a couple of foul shots. So Levitt sinks it. The foul on Ryan Fortier of Mount Blue is his second.
64% free throw shooter on the year is Levitt.
And Levitt will get one out of two, and the loose ball picked up by Brewer out front. Rob Pawson comes up with it. Gives it off to Chris Corson. Brewer leads by a point with 2:05 to go in the first half. They must win to make the tournament. The good news is Coney lost to Lawrence. Baseline shot is missed by Rob Pawson. The rebound won't go by Pawson. And a Mount Blue foul.
Looks like it's going to be on Joe McLaughlin inside as he really gave up some position inside. Some pretty good rebounding offensively by Pawson. This is something that they did not do early in the ballgame that they are doing right now. They're hitting the offensive glass a little bit more.
Levitt going to the bench, and John Bennett comes in for him. And the foul on McLaughlin, his second. And on the foul line, Rob Pawson, a junior. Pawson shooting two, misses the first one. Minute 51 to go in the first half. And Troy Wilkins back in the game for Mount Blue, replacing 31 Joe McLaughlin, who's toweling off some sweat with a minute 51 to go in the half. Fawcett struggling from the foul line. Rebound Wilkins for Mount Blue. Here come the Cougars. On the baseline, a spin up and in. Ryan Fortier hung on the back of the rim for a moment. Dropped in. And now it's a Mount Blue lead, 34-33, as we swap back and forth with a minute 30 to go in the first half. Shot is up from the outside. It's no good. Bennett on the rebound. John Bennett with the basket.
Good weak side rebounding again by the Brewer Witches.
Brewer's back on top. Drive to the hoop. The shot won't go for Jeremy Bryant, but he did draw a foul against Brewer.
He was set up and didn't move laterally on the offensive player, and that's why he was called for the hat.
It's on John Bennett. That's his third. And Jeremy Bryant on the foul line, averaging over 10 points a game, making the foul shot. He has 9 tonight.
One.
Game's tied at 35. Bryant will get the bounce, put Mount Blue back on top, and the lead has changed hands several times in this game.
A lot of lead changes, and I have a funny feeling we're going to see a few more before this one's over.
Minute 10 to go in the half. Brewer breaks the press, but they lose the ball as James Hinckley turned around and lost the handle on it, and now Mount Blue loses the handle on it too. Jim Ross last touched it, and it will be Brewer ball with a minute 2 to go. And Jim Bessie says, I saw it differently, doing a little dance there in front of the Mount Blue bench.
He didn't feel it was out of bounds.
Across the middle, the shot is missed by Buddy Chambers.
It's going to be called on Brewer, James Hinckley.
Brewer foul, yeah, number 50, James Hinckley. And where it is 1-1, they'll take a walk down to the other end for foul shots, and that's 3 on Hinckley. I'm rather 1 on Hinckley.
Now they're in the, both teams actually are in the double bonus.
All right,
situation.
With the 10 fouls on the team, so shooting 2. Mark Savage, man with a great sense of humor. But right now, it's all business. Foul shot by Dustin Ireland is good. Shooting 2 in the double bonus. Sometimes I forget about because we don't always get up to that 10-point stage. A 10-foul stage, rather. As Fortier comes out of the game, and for him is Eric Miskin, number 15. Dustin Ireland with 6 points tonight has another foul shot coming to him after making the last one. And it's a little short. Rebound, James Hinckley for Brewer. 45 seconds to go in the half. Little alley-oop play down low. The shot is up and in by Buddy Chambers. Brewer ties it at 37.
Good job of seeing the floor that time by the Brewer offense, and Chambers laid it in.
Almost in the backcourt, but it's stolen by Brewer. Hinckley comes up with it. Gives it off to Chris Corson. And Brewer will go for one shot here, I believe.
Big offensive possession for the Brewer Witches. 18 seconds remaining, got it at 37.
Fawson with the basketball. Nice switch of the hands on the dribble. Comes up short, though. On the rebound, it's pulled down by Dustin Ireland, and a Brewer foul. Looks like maybe Bennett. Mark Savage pacing and...
called on Pawson, I believe.
Was it Pawson?
Pawson will pick up his second personal. We're going to go down the other end and shoot 2 foul shots.
I guess Bennett was just looking guilty, trying to help out there.
Really good job by Pawson to see in the floor the last time down. Nice catch by Buddy Chambers. Good up fake. Laid it off the glass for the easy 2.
Pawson picks up his second. And Dustin Ireland is on the foul line for Mount Blue. 9 seconds remaining in the half. Tied at 37, now Mount Blue with the lead. As Jason Leighton and Adam King check back in, Bennett will come out, also Pawson is out. Coming up at halftime, Tim Throckmorton. Not to be confused with Terrors of the Deep, which is supposed to be on right now, will be shown Monday night at 7. Foul shot is up and in by Ireland. It's a two-point lead for Mount Blue with 9 seconds on the clock. Brewer will try to get a shot up. And in the double team, it's a Mount Blue foul.
Okay, now we're going to get on the other end and shoot a pair of foul shots. So some key foul shots on both sides of the coin here with just a few seconds remaining until halftime.
Both teams with an opportunity to take advantage of the double bonus.
I tell you what, Michael, it doesn't get any better than this. Listen to the crowd, a close ball game, a huge ball game for Brewer, a great prep game for the tournament for Mount Blue. It just doesn't get any better than this.
Chris Corson on the foul line makes the first of two. And Ryan Fortier checked out briefly. He'll come back in. Eric Miskin will go to the bench. 7 seconds on the clock as we near halftime. Nice foul shooting by Chris Corson and Brewer to tie it at 39. Let's see if Mount Blue can get a shot off before the halftime buzzer. In the backcourt, it's stolen by Brewer. Off to Leighton. Leighton baseline. He won't get it at the buzzer. And what a game is tied at 39 between Mount Blue and Brewer at halftime. We'll come back with Tim Throckmorton at the half in just a moment.
WABI TV sports coverage of high school basketball is brought to you by Bean and Conquest Chevrolet Geo and Village Subaru, proud sponsors of high school sports.
Just rolling out of bed, do not look outside.
The new Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo offers an available V8 and full-time four-wheel drive.
On the way, buses are running behind.
Anti-lock disc brakes and dual airbags.
Getting through.
Plus a lease rate of just $369 a month with no money down.
It's a great day for snowmen.
Making the new Jeep Grand Cherokee greatly underappreciated by school kids everywhere.
See your New England Jeep and Eagle dealers. Innovation, leadership, style. The all-new Polaris 1996 ATVs are ready for inspection. You won't believe your eyes. Check out the Sportsman 500, the only ATV with a four-stroke liquid-cooled 500cc engine, shaft drive, and independent rear suspension. For hunting, working, or just plain getting around, there's nothing like a Polaris ATV. Choose your model today.
You could never wear a suit again. You could not laugh when it's not funny. You could go off and write that novel, climb that mountain, buy those shoes. You could fly in the face of convention, or drive there. Find your own road. Saab.
Coldbrook Saab, Route 201, Skowhegan.
Welcome back to the Brewer High Gym. We're watching perform at halftime the PAL Brewer High All-Star Cheerleaders. These are fourth and fifth graders who made the All-Star team, and here they are in action.
Our team, master of your team. You got the best magic ever made. You got the power in your corner. Heavy ammunition in your hand.
What you wish is yours, true dish. My little more Bobby Bob. As I'm a kind of man, turn all of kind of me.
PAL cheerleaders will be performing, or competing, I guess, in Waterville tomorrow. So we wish them the best of luck. We're joined now by Dave Jeffrey, who has been around a long time. If you know this face, you've been to some track meets locally. He's the track coach here at Brewer High School. Congratulations, Dave. A great year for the boys and girls. The boys winning their first state championship under your guidance.
We had a tremendous year this year, Tim. From start to finish, it was just really great. The kids really performed, and we're really happy.
You know, the numbers, it just astounds me how many kids you have come out, but I guess a successful program, kids want to be part of it. Why is it? Do you think that's the reason that you get so many bodies out?
Well, I think the success has something to do with it. I think the kids have a lot of fun, and I think they know when they come in that they're going to achieve some personal success. So I think those things all go together, and a lot of kids come out.
You know, we watched Peter Phelan during the football season, and we were just astounded by his performance, reaching a national scale in the triple jump. Were you surprised at all about how quickly he surfaced into such a terrific triple jumper?
He had a great junior year, and it kind of went unnoticed. He was state champion last spring, and I just think as kids mature and they get older, they get to that next level, and he just rose to the next level. I mean, he's a national caliber athlete. There's no question about it.
You still having fun coaching?
Oh, having a great time. It's been a great season. I'll have to do it a while longer. This girls' team is very, very young, so I'll have to stay around a while longer.
Certainly congratulations, and we'll get some banners up here next year for your accomplishments.
Well, hopefully. Thank you very much,
Good
Tim.
Job. Dave Jeffrey, of course, the Brewer High School track coach, and we're back here to the Bangor Auditorium to talk a little bit about who's going to make the tournament in Class A right after this.
The Tommy Gate from Maine Equipment Company saves time, increases versatility, and is an inexpensive alternative to workers' comp. For more money-saving ideas, call Maine Equipment today.
If you're just rolling out of bed, do not look outside.
The new Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo offers an available V8 and full-time four-wheel drive.
On the way, buses are running behind.
Anti-lock disc brakes and dual airbags.
Getting through.
Plus a lease rate of just $369 a month with no money down.
It's a great day.
Making the new Jeep Grand Cherokee greatly underappreciated by school kids everywhere.
See your New England Jeep and Eagle dealers.
Hi, I'm Judy. For as long as I've owned Farmington Furniture, I've never been so excited, and I know you will be too. We have added a new home theater wall and motion furniture gallery to our showroom. Everything we offer is personally selected and priced by me. So, for that personal touch in new home furnishings with owner-to-you pricing, when you think of furniture, think of Farmington.
Farmington Furniture and Mattress Company, that's the way it's supposed to be.
Progress is the movement toward a specific goal or further stage. For Husson College, progress means preparing a center of modern education for Maine students. It means offering students new social, spiritual, and cultural opportunities. And while Husson College is progressing, we remain committed to the tradition of a quality education with individual attention. Come visit us and see why we're Maine's College of Business, Health, and Professional Studies. Husson College, progress for the students of tomorrow.
We are back, and as you can see, score is all knotted up at 39 apiece, and Brewer's got a little bit of work to do, but upon hearing the news that Lawrence had beaten Coney at the end of the first half, Mark Savage kind of pumped his fist saying, okay, that's out of the way. They need a little help. Now they're going to have to do the rest themselves. 16 minutes to go. Michael.
Thank you, Tim. We'll see a lot of juggling of the standings. Bangor has a big game tomorrow night against Old Town. And what a matchup that is, your 2-3 matchup right now in the heel point standing. So still some important games going down the stretch over the next couple of days.
Boy, none more important than this one right now as far as teams getting in. The Bangor-Old Town game, important as far as who's going to go number one. Mm-hmm. Apparently the winner of that ball game looks to go number one. The loser to go either two or three. So all kinds of movement, and that's what it's all about, Mike. You have the last couple of days of the regular season, and you have teams jostling for position, jostling to get in. You couldn't ask for a better situation.
All I know is if I go in at number one and Brewer ends at number eight, I wouldn't want to play Brewer in the opening round.
Absolutely.
As we see some good balanced scoring here, Tom, at halftime.
The key, 40 with 14, they've got to control that. Bryant with 10, Ireland with 8 for the Cougars. Johnston with 10, Leighton with 8, and Levitt with 7 for the Witches. Key really, Mike, in the second half, they've got to make sure, Brewer is, got to make sure that they control Mount Blue inside. I thought they did a better job of that in the second quarter, but they still need to get a better job off the offensive glass than they have in the first half of play.
Oh, it's been close all the way. Brewer jumped out to a 2-0 lead. Mount Blue led for a while. Lead changed hands several times in this game. And at the end of the first quarter, Mount Blue led 19-16 and all knotted up here at 39 at the half. This Brewer team, I've seen them play only twice this year against Bangor at the auditorium. and here tonight, and I'm just really surprised that this team is 8-9. Don't forget, coming up Friday, a week from tomorrow night, we'll have the girls and boys Class B state championship right here on Channel 5. And of course, the next day is Class A's long quarterfinal day, beginning after 8 o'clock in the morning. There it is, all day long, right into the late night hours. We'll have a busy crew bringing you all the games from the Bangor Auditorium here on Channel 5. So lots of basketball ahead. We'll take a break, and we'll be back with third period in just a moment.
Channel 5 sports coverage of high school basketball is brought to you by your main GMC truck dealers, the only pure truck dealer with the strength of experience.
.39 the score between Mount Blue and Brewer. Mike Hale and Tom Winston with you. Tim Throckmorton wandering down along the floor, probably out to get a hot dog by now. So Mount Blue 12-5, number 6 in the last standings we had as of games played through last night. Brewer number 11 at 8-9. But as we see the standings, it's anything but a 11-6 matchup here. Look at the bottom there. Anything could happen down in the bottom of that pack, and Brewer looks like they'll slip into that number 8 spot. Coney is 9-9 after losing to Lawrence tonight. Lawrence now 10-8.
Presque Isle is also 10-8 as they picked up a win up at home against Nokomis. So again, still all kinds of movement here in the standings, and that's what it's all about.
Channel 5 water bottles, which are a lot of fun, courtesy of the AG stores, the cheerleaders of Brewer, tossing some water bottles up to the huge crowd here at Brewer High School tonight. And those Brewer cheerleaders always seem to be so talented. They entertained at halftime, and they're always winning titles, and enjoyed watching them at halftime.
Boy, a lot of new young people to that Brewer cheerleading squad, too. In addition, one senior that has never been a cheerleader prior to this year, and Alicia Gilmore, and just did a wonderful job. Eastern Maine champions, what else can you say?
Well, I think it's time to take off the jacket and get ready for the second half, because I have a feeling it's going to be close and hot, because we're tied here at halftime. When these teams met first this season, it was 67-64, Mount Blue won. And when they met in the tournament last year, Jason Leighton heaved up that full court shot to have number 4 Brewer, number 5 at that time last season. So these teams do know how to entertain on the basketball court.
And they've done a good job of that tonight. Knotted at 39 with the second half play-by-play, Mike Hale.
Why, thank you, Tom Winston. An introduction and everything. And it's thrown into the backcourt. Chased down for the violation by Nate Freeman.
Not the way you want to open your offense in the second half with a turnover.
Mount Blue underneath their basket. It's into Wilkins. Jim Ross will fire it up for 2. Ross, a 6'3 junior, hasn't done a lot of scoring in this game, but he finds the distance here early in the third period.
He made a key three-pointer in the first half to not to score at 32, but that's about all we've heard from him.
On the baseline, King drives, and foul on Mount Blue. It'll be number 20, Ryan Fortier. First foul of the second half. On 40, or that's 2. Mount Blue leads by a basket here in the second half. Into Leighton. Leighton in traffic puts it up. It won't go. And it's knocked out of bounds by Mount Blue as Dustin Ireland got a hand on it.
That's simply a lack of communication. You did a great job of boxing out by Mount Blue, but no communication. 3 Mount Blue players right there, and they knock it out.
And a question, Mark Savage, to one of the officials, Mr. Harmon and Mr. Shoppy, are tonight's officials. Oh, they had maybe a little bit of an argument on who the foul actually was on, and Mark Savage wanted to correct the scoreboard, which had actually Dustin Ireland up there. And that's a big foul.
That's a huge foul.
Because Ryan Fortier has 3, so heads up by Coach Savage.
Smart play, Coach Savage, in picking that one up.
He's not just another pretty face. And both teams a little sloppy here to start the third period. The shot will be short by Jeremy Bryan. It's battled for in the paint, and it'll be tied up.
It'll be Mount Blue possession.
The arrow will give it to Mount Blue. Very early in the third period, Coach Bessie begs to differ.
We got the Bessie shuffle going again. John Sharpie's not going to take any of that, I can tell you that right now.
Mount Blue with the ball and a two-point lead, 7 minutes to go in the third. Ross gives it off to Fortier. That's 14 points in the game. It's stolen by Brewer. Was knocked loose by Johnston. Up ahead, it's Nate Freeman with a layup to tie it at 41.
What a great lead pass that time by Troy Levitt. Mm.
Levitt and Johnston with the steal, then the nice pass. Quickly the other way, the shot is up and in. Dustin Ireland, number 22, scores for Mount Blue to put the Cougars back on top, 43-41. 6:25 to go in the third. Freeman to Leighton. Leighton finds daylight on the baseline. It's blocked from behind, but the body is there, and it's a Mount Blue foul.
Jason Leighton really created that situation because he did a nice job of protecting the basketball from the defender. Thus, he's going to be at the foul line to shoot a pair of foul shots.
Dustin Ireland.
Watch the job he does of protecting the basketball right there, and he really got knocked from behind by Ireland.
Second on Ireland, and a little hula hoop there, and it won't go for Leighton. Leighton doesn't miss many. And he gets that one. Mount Blue 43, Brewer 42. 6:15 to go in the third. You get the big guy. Wilkins at 6'6", bringing the ball up the court for Mount Blue. Off to Ross now. Ross to the foul line, off to Fortier. Fortier's been quiet so far here in the third period. After having 14 in the first half, he had 28 in the first game they played. Down low, pass intended for Wilkins. He couldn't hang on to it and is picked off by Freeman. Leighton with a nice fake, puts it up and in.
Good fundamental basketball again by Jason Leighton. Got him that basket.
If he hadn't faked and hesitated, that would have been blocked. Instead, Brewer's on top, 44-43. There's a drive down the middle. Block is by Levitt. He blocked Bryant, but Mount Blue comes away with the basketball. Down low, left wide open. Troy Wilkins for the basket.
Just a little bit of lack of communication from the Brewer defense.
And the lead changes again with Mount Blue on top of Brewer, 45-44, 5:20 to go in the third. King loses the handle. It's picked up by Fortier. One-on-one. Fortier shoots over King for the basket. Ryan Fortier with his 16th point of the night. The three-point lead for Mount Blue. 5 minutes to go in the third. Shot by Freeman is no good, but the foul will be called on Mount Blue. Jeremy Bryant was in the vicinity, number 23. See if that's on him. And it is. Bryant of Mount Blue picking up his second, and it'll be third on the team as Eric Miskin checks into the game to replace Jim Ross for Mount Blue. Also, King's coming out. Pawson is in for King. As Freeman misses the foul shot. Nate Freeman, senior. He gets one out of two. It's a two-point game. Mount Blue on top. Nice double team. Mount Blue will pass out of it. It's Miskin into the front court. Down on the baseline, Fortier on the miss as he puts up the running jumper. And the rebound, Levitt. Off to Pawson. Pawson into the front court. 4:45 to go in the third. Brewer down by a basket. It's Pawson with the ball. Out to Freeman. Now it's Levitt. Levitt in the paint, pull-up jumper. Had to change his shot, he still got it. He had a hand in his face. Changed his shot, got it to fall.
What a great athletic move by Levitt to score that jump shot.
He's having a good game. Foul on Freeman of Brewer. The shot by Levitt tied the game at 47 with 4:16 to go in the third. Freeman reaching in.
Another substitution from Mount Blue as Scott Merrick checks it back into the ballgame. And he's going to replace Ryan Fortier.
Foul on Freeman, his second. It's only the first team foul on Brewer in the second half. And Jeremy Bryant of Mount Blue brings it into the front court. Off to Miskin. Eric Miskin down underneath. The shot is a pretty one. It's up and in. Scott Myrick, who just came into the game, made a nice pump move underneath. Protected the ball well.
Did a good job of protecting the basketball, used the baseline, got the hoop.
Leighton pull-up jumper on the baseline. He won't get it, but he's run into, and Leighton will go to the line and shoot two.
Hard foul that time by Eric Miskin. You can see as Leighton decides he's going to go to the hoop, pulls up, takes the J, and he's going to get hammered on the shot. And he goes to the line to try to knock this game up at 49.
Eric Miskin picks up his fourth. And so Miskin will come out of the game. In for him is Jim Ross. Fourth team foul on Mount Blue. And Jason Leighton is on the foul line. He averages over 14 points a game and hits the foul shot. He has 12 tonight. Leighton eyes the hoop, buries the second one. We're tied at 49 with 3:53 to go in the third. A violation on Mount Blue, or was it a foul? Foul on Brewer, I guess. Looks like Mike Johnston.
No, they're not going to call a foul. They're going to call a warning for breaking the plane
of
the end line. First time it's a warning. If he had made contact with the ball, it's a technical foul. But where he just broke the plane, it's a warning. If they do it again, it's a technical foul.
He came over to the table and said number 5-2. So not a foul, but a warning not to do it again. Next time it's a technical. We're tied at 49, 3:40 to go in the third. Brewer needs this win to make the tournament. If they lose, they're out. So it's a big game for the Witches and a tune-up game for Mount Blue. There's a three-pointer in the corner by number 23, Jeremy Bryant. We haven't seen too many of the three-pointers in the game tonight on either side. A couple. And it's knocked out of bounds by Mount Blue. Brewer will put it in front of their own bench.
You can see the ball going into the corner right in front of the Mount Blue bench, and Brian's going to get it behind the three-point line. Lots of time, and nails it.
Freeman with the ball for Brewer. Off to Pawson. Posting up is Johnston. Johnston shoots over Wilkins and misses. Pawson with a rebound, dumps it off underneath, and we get a holding foul beyond number 24, and that's Scott Myrick. Clock stopped at 2:58 to go in the third. It's a three-point lead for Mount Blue, 52-49. Not a shooting foul, so Brewer puts it in underneath. Johnston puts it into Freeman. Freeman gets loose underneath for the basket.
Sort of a baby hook by Freeman, enabling him to get open.
It's a one-point ball game. Mount Blue leading by one. 2:40 to go in the third. And we have a foul on Brewer.
Foul on the inside on Brewer, and it's going to be on Troy Leighton.
Troy Levitt, that's his second. There's a three-point shot out front. It's up and in. Scott Myrick, number 24. And that puts Mount Blue on top, 55-51, 2:20 to go in the third. In the paint, Leighton's shot is no good. A foul is called on 21, Jim Ross.
Boy, fouls starting to mount up on both sides. That's a sixth personal foul this time. On the Mount Blue Cougars.
Couldn't ask for a better game than what we're watching here. 2:21 to go in the third. Must win for Brewer, and a fun game to watch. Leighton buries it on the foul line. This has the makings of being one of those screamers at the end.
Absolutely.
Another overtime buzzer beater, possibly from...
another half-court shot, maybe?
Does Leighton have another one in it? Both foul shots good by Jason, and it's a 55-53 lead for Mount Blue. Jeremy Bryant brings it up. He's picked up at half-court by Nate Freeman. Bryant switches hands nicely. Gets the ball off to Myrick. Myrick, who showed us he can hit out three-point line, goes down low to Wilkins, and Wilkins will draw the foul.
Mount Blue doing a nice job on their offensive rotation that time. And got somebody free on the block and got him a good look at the hoop.
And Brewer and Mark Savage sends in his five replacement players. He does it somewhere right around the two-minute mark.
A little bit different rotation here as King's going to be with this group along with Chambers. And let's see, who else?
Chris Corson is in there.
Corson.
John Bennett.
And Bennett.
And the only difference, King was on the bench at the time, and he came in with the five new players. Of course, King is a starter. Foul on Freeman was his third, the team's third, and Troy Wilkins, a 6'6 junior center, is on the foul line for the Mount Blue Cougars, and he has the shot. It's a three-point lead for Mount Blue. 2 minutes, 4 seconds to go in the third. Mike Hale and Tom Winston with you, along with Tim Throckmorton. Foul shot is good, second time around as well. 57-53. Mount Blue, 2 minutes to go, third. It's Bennett with the basketball, off to King. King out front is guarded by Ross. Ross goes up and fouls him.
Boy, Ross was going at him all the way down on that drive, and they're letting a little bit of that go this time, but he committed the personal foul on the shot. King will go to line to shoot two.
Jim Ross picks up number three, seventh on the team, as Ryan Fortier comes back into the game.
Scott Myrick takes a seat on the bench next to Coach Bessett.
I don't know if I'd want to be on that seat next to Coach right now. He's very animated. Adam King missing the foul shot, but he has another one coming his way. One out of two for King. And it cuts the lead to three for Mount Blue. 1:40 to go in the third.
Brewer's got to make sure that they knock down those easy ones in a close game that means so much. Those foul shots are going to be all important down the stretch.
Ryan Fortier will give it off to Bryant. Back to Fortier. Down low, Wilkins in a double team. Dishes it off. They bring it back out front. Back to Wilkins. Cross court. Jim Ross with a three-point attempt. It rolls off the top of the backboard and hits the iron. Channel 5 fan cam picking up the Brewer winch. Enjoying the game, flew in on the broom tonight to catch this one.
Might fly away if the Witches aren't successful in this one.
That's true. Some pressure put on by Mount Blue. Brewer just gets it across in time. And it's King, has it nearly stolen. Nice hustle in there by Jim Ross, but Brewer hangs on to it. Buddy Chambers in the paint, we'll get it to go. Nice move by the junior in off the bench. Buddy Chambers makes it a one-point ball game. 45 seconds to go in the third. Mount Blue leading by a point as we near the end of the third period. And they'll go for the last shot. Jeremy Bryant holding the basketball near midcourt. Clock down to 17 seconds. Coach Bessie gives the go-ahead to Bryant to push it in. They swing it over to Ross. Ross out front to Fortier. Fortier in the paint, dishes off down low. Nice pass, gets loose. It's put up and in by Troy Wilkins. It will count. And a foul on Brewer. Wow.
Again, the same situation as we talked about earlier. Mount Blue catching the basketball on the block. Pretty easy in the offensive rotation. You'll see they just get it inside too easily there as the ball in the paint for Mount Blue again and again tonight. And that's something, if Brewer's going to come back and win this one, they've got to stop from happening.
It was off the hands of Ireland, bounced right into the hands of Wilkins. He made the layup. He misses. Brewer 56. We're back in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Erin Lachance of Cherry Theater at Brewer High School, and you're watching Channel 5 sports coverage of Class A basketball on the home of high school sports, WABI-TV. Let's go, Channel 5! Yeah!
It's a commitment to customer demand for exceptional livability that keeps the excitement going in Hitchhiker Fifth Wheels, available at Good Times Unlimited in Farmington, Maine. Of course, experienced drivers have known for years that Hitchhiker leads the way in producing fifth wheels that have the most desired features. More and more serious drivers are buying a Hitchhiker Fifth Wheel for the residential living atmosphere. Isn't it time you joined the rapidly growing list of satisfied Hitchhiker Fifth Wheel owners? Visit Good Times Unlimited soon, Route 2, Farmington, to see the Hitchhiker that most excites you.
Back at Brewer High School, Mike Hale and Tom Winston, and a couple of program notes. CBS special Terrors of the Deep, scheduled for 8 tonight, will be shown Monday night at 7, and Rescue 911, which is supposed to be coming on the air in about 10 minutes, will be shown Saturday night at 11:30.
Terrors of the Deep might be a good title for this fourth quarter for the Brewer Witches.
That's right, they need the win. They're down by 3. Levitt with the basketball. And it looks like Mount Blue has turned up the heat a little bit on defense. Much more aggressive right now. In the paint, Hinkley, rather Johnston on the miss. Rebound Mount Blue. And Brewer's going to have to play some pretty good defense themselves. They're down by 3. They want to stay close here in the fourth period. Fortier on the baseline.
Key call right here. They're going to call a play of control foul on Ryan Fortier. That will be foul number 4 as Fortier got the ball out on the left, took the ball.
Might be a good call.
You see the right arm being pushed away. Originally, I didn't agree with that, but it looked like it.
Whether or not it really had any impact, nevertheless, he did move his arm forward. And let's take another look at that, Tom.
Let's see if they're going to call that play of control. Fortier had the ball, so they're going to have to call a play of control.
This could have gone either way, really.
He better not say too much to these officials. They're not going to put up with it for a whole lot. But I can't understand why they're getting foul shots here.
Now the official coming over to discuss the fact on what's up here.
Let's put it this way. It's foul number 4 on Ryan Fortier. They called a player control foul, but they couldn't have called a player control foul, really, because they wouldn't be shooting foul shots. What they must have ruled, let's see if he had possession this time. He has possession here, but there it is. The ball's coming loose. That's why they're calling that foul after the ball was knocked loose. And there it's a charge and not a player control. If he has possession of the ball and is called for the personal foul in that situation, it's no shooting, Brewer possession underneath. Lost possession first.
End of class, huh? Troy Levitt makes both foul shots, nevertheless, and the fourth foul for Ryan Fortier. And it was a big play. Traveling violation there on Mount Blue. But that play made it, instead of 59-56, the foul shots by Levitt is 59-58. So a big call on that foul. And on the turnover, Brewer gets the ball back off the travel with 7:05 to go in the game. They're down by just a point. Posting up, Johnston spins. Oh, boy, did he get the bounce on that one. I think there was a little Brewer witch that flew up there and tapped that one in.
That's a good call. That is a very good call. Levitt got in position to take the charge, then just moved a little bit as the offense went behind him. Nice shooter's roll last time down. Mike Johnson with the turnaround. Looks like it's going to fall out here. Rolls in.
Wow. 60-59. Brewer has the lead back with 6:51 to go in the game. Pawson is coming out. King is back in for Brewer. Mount Blue with the ball underneath their basket.
Original starting 5 back in for Brewer. 6:51 remaining.
All right. Fortier missing the three-point attempt. It'll be Brewer ball as it's chased out of bounds by Jeremy Bryant. And the fans are really getting into this now. 6:46 to go. Brewer up by a point, and we'll stress again, Brewer must win to make the tournament. Freeman baseline.
Player control.
Player control. The basket will not count. No basket. Player control foul against Nate Freeman.
Let's take a look at that. As Freeman decides to take the ball to the baseline, strong against Fortier, he leaned in. Official thinking he caused the contact.
That's
and
four.
And he'll pick up his fourth personal. That could have been the fifth personal on Ryan Fortier. So Mount Blue escaping a serious, serious problem there as far as Fortier was concerned.
Mount Blue facing some pressure in the backcourt. Jim Ross doing the ball handling, brings it quickly into the front court. Shot from the corner would be good for three, is missed by Jeremy Bryant. The follow is no good by McLaughlin, and the rebound Brewer. It's Jason Leighton with the basketball. Off to Chris Corson for three, comes up short. Rebound Johnston.
Johnson's going to be called for an over-the-back foul. Tough to tell from here.
Foul on Mike Johnston on the back, and both teams over the limit now. That's number seven on Brewer as a team. So both teams in the 1-1. And that's foul number two on Johnston. And on the foul line will be Joe McLaughlin from Mount Blue.
We talked earlier tonight about the importance of foul shooting down the stretch. Both teams in the bonus for the remaining 6-10. Certainly every one of these is going to be important.
A chance to win it or lose it for yourself, possibly, on the foul line. As the junior, 6'4", junior Joe McLaughlin makes the first one, and Eric Miskin is checking into the game, number 15, replacing Ryan Fortier, number 20. He is the leading scorer on the team, but he's playing with four fouls right now. 6:10 to go in the game. We're tied at 60. Foul shot is no good. Second time around, one out of two. For McLaughlin, Brewer on the rebound. And bringing it up is Adam King. It's Corson to Leighton. Leighton on the baseline. In the double team, gives it up to Levitt. Cross court, Corson quickly to Leighton. Leighton in the paint, pull up jumper is good. Brewer leads 62-60 with 5:45 to go. And it will be lost out of bounds by Mount Blue. They tried to pass over the full court pressure.
Okay, great play by Leighton last time down. Pulls up in the middle of the lane, knocks down the jumper. Defensively on the other end, great play by Troy Levitt as the ball was thrown ahead into the forecourt for Mount Blue. He wouldn't allow the Mount Blue player to get possession of the ball.
Brewer leads by a basket, 5.5 minutes to go in the game. It's Johnston in the paint. It's stolen away nicely by Jeremy Bryant. Bryant on the breakaway layup. And Levitt might have got a hand on it. He misses. Levitt with a big defensive play for Brewer. Looked like a sure thing for Bryant, but Levitt was there.
You could see Levitt coming from the weak side. He wanted to get at that one, and he did.
Intimidated a little bit, too. As Corson drives down the middle, he'll be fouled and go to the line for two. Corson with a move down the middle.
Great aggressive move by Chris Corson. Left-handed with the ball, takes it into the middle. He was hacked on the shot.
And Eric Miskin is fouled out of the game. We'll take a quick 30-second timeout with 5:03 to go.
Practicality is part of what keeps Maine great, like only one vehicle to do the work of two or three. That's why more family cars and minivans in Maine are turning into family trucks. And Maine's family truck of choice is GMC Club Group. Only the company that builds only trucks can bring you more truck for less bucks, often for less money than a minivan or car. So vanquish the Voyager, cash in the Caravan, trade in that Taurus. One test drive today and you too may say it's GMC Pure Truck for me and the family.
5:03 to go in this game. Mike Hale and Tom Winston with you along with Tim Throckmorton. Brewer leads 62-60. 5:03 to go in the game. Eric Miskin fouled out with that foul.
I want to know why Mr. Shoppy didn't jump up and get that net.
It's quiet in there. You could have heard a pin drop when Chris Corson put up the foul shot, but it's good. Brewer by three. Forcing in off the bench, a junior. Rolls around the rim and out. Dustin Ireland with a rebound off to Jeremy Bryant. Fortier with a nice spin move at the foul line. He drops it in.
Oh, great defense, too, that time by Troy Levin. That just shows you what kind of a player Fortier really is.
It's not an easy shot. King with a three-pointer. It's missed. And the rebound, Dustin Ireland again. 4:25 to go in the game. Wilkins for two. He misses. Rebound, King. Leighton brings it up for Brewer. Down the middle. Leans in, drops it over the front of the rim. Concentrating and taking it to the hoop was Jason Leighton. Brewer leads 65-62, 4:05 to go. Ryan Fortier misses from near the foul line. A rebound forcing for Brewer. And it will be out of bounds. Who's the last touch by? Last touch by Mount Blue on a heads-up play by Chris Corson, who actually bounced it off the Mount Blue player who was out of bounds.
That's he called a make right in front of Jim Bessie, though.
What a game. 3:55 to go. Brewer 65, Mount Blue 62. Brewer must win to make the tournament.
This is what high school sports is all about.
It's a great way to chase away the winter blues and cabin fever, I'll tell you, to catch some of these games. Knocked out of bounds by Mount Blue. And Brewer will put it in underneath their basket.
Nice idea by Johnston, but he's got to be careful when he turns around and tries to go baseline. Make sure he protects the basketball a little bit better.
3:35 to go. Brewer by three, trying to spread it out here. Late, won't get the roll. Rebound, Ryan Fortier.
Really got caught a little bit too deep to make an attempt there, but almost got it to go.
Ryan Fortier. They work it back out front. Jim Ross missing at the foul line and a whistle on the rebound. It's like a Brewer foul.
It is, and again, we talked about, you know, rebounding and foul shooting down the stretch going to be keys. With that, Mount Blue, I guess, is going to want timeout, Mike.
Looks like Troy Levitt fouls out of the game. We're back in a moment.
Since 1868, Franklin Savings Bank has been helping Farmington, Wilton, and area residents with their financial needs. An experienced staff of local professionals assures you of quality and convenient financial services. Whether it's buying a home, purchasing a car, financing a small business, or investing your hard-earned money, the people at Franklin Savings Bank stand ready to assist you.
You have my commitment that our staff will give you the personal service that you expect from hometown bankers.
Welcome back to Brewer High School. Brewer leading Mount Blue 65-62, 3:13 to go in the game. And Troy Levitt did not foul out of the game. They had five up there, now they have four. So Levitt is in the game for Brewer. Actually, he's not in the game because we have some new blood in. And it's Pawson into the game. Rob Pawson replacing Levitt.
Key time of the ball game, Pawson into Levitt. Pawson doing a nice job earlier off the bench. He's going to need some key minutes from Pawson in order to succeed here.
Dustin Ireland on the foul line. Misses the first one. 3:13 to go in this game. Brewer 65, Mount Blue 62. Ireland missing the first one and makes the second one. Another two-point game. Full court pressure by the Mount Blue Cougars. It's into Corson in the double team. He has a hard time. He gets it away to Johnston. And the front court is Pawson, and some really aggressive defense by Mount Blue right now. Under 3 minutes to go now, 2:55. Brewer by a basket. Late. Off to Corson. Now it's King out front.
Brewer going to take some time off the clock here, leading by two with 2:40 remaining.
Well, they want to make sure they get a good shot. It's nearly stolen. It's knocked loose from behind. Nice hustle by Mount Blue, though. You have to say, Jim Ross and Dustin Ireland hitting the floor. And you can hear their knees scraping on the floor, but they lose it out of bounds.
And again, we see the Bessie Shuffley. You know, it's great. All the coaches, including the couple here tonight, have great vision from there. They want the call to go their way.
Very emotional. It's a big game. And low collision underneath. The ball is loose. It's picked up by Mount Blue. Jeremy Bryant is going to be fouled. And that will, I believe, be number 5 on Freeman.
Boy, I tell you, that's the first one that I think they may have looked away from, because there was a pretty good collision at the foul line that a call may have been made one way or the other, but no call, and now we're going to get out on the other end and shoot 1-1.
As Nate Freeman fouls out of the game with 2:24 to go, and the Brewer Witches leading Mount Blue 65-63. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
Congratulations to the Mount Blue Cougars for a fantastic season and advancing to the tournaments. The following area merchants are behind you all the way. F.L. Butler on Front Street in Farmington. Affordable steak and seafood dining with atmosphere. Riverside Greenhouses of Farmington. Come feel spring with a walk in our greenhouses. 1-800-564-3566. Best of luck to the Mount Blue Cougars. We're behind you 100%.
Some Mount Blue fans made the trip up from the Farmington area tonight to cheer on their Mount Blue Cougars. We see a pretty good contingency. And 2:24 to go in the game at 65-63. Brewers leading Mount Blue, and Nate Freeman fouled out of the game just before we took the short break. And going to the foul line is Jeremy Bryant. Shooting 1-1. Both teams have committed 9 here, so one more foul each, and we're in the double bonus.
Bangor High Coach Roger Heen here watching this one.
Foul shot is missed, and a big miss on the foul line. Rebound Brewer, knocked out by Mount Blue. By the way, Troy Levitt came back into the game to replace Freeman, who fouled out.
We also have a foul in the rebounding action. Mount Blue. Now Brewer will go and shoot 2 foul shots as they're in the double bonus. Jim Bessie.
Do you think it would be a good idea to have a microphone on Jim Bessie tonight?
I don't know if they rate basketball games or not.
Oh, and Sam, we should mic up the coaches. No, we couldn't do that.
I think the FCC might have something to say about that one.
Foul shot is up and in by Rob Pawson, who was fouled by Jeremy Bryant, his 3rd, shooting a double bonus as Mount Blue picked up their 10th team foul. 2:20 to go, Brewer by 3. Make that 4, 67-63.
Brewer still in their full court pressure, kind of a soft pressure, just allowing time to go off the clock.
2:10 to go in this game. Ryan Fortier with the ball, goes down to Wilkins. Wilkins with a strong move, he gets it. Troy Wilkins. Big basket for the 6'6 junior. 67-65, Brewer by a basket, minute 50 to go. King with the ball. Pass down low intended for Johnston. Nice denied defense by Troy Wilkins to knock the ball away.
Just some good ball movement that time by Mount Blue. Inside, they get it, and Wilkins with a good turnaround knocks it down. With that, Brewer wants timeout.
Brewer calling a timeout. They lead by a basket with a minute 44 to go. We'll be back in just a moment.
At Taylor Rental and Brewer, we have the experience and the equipment to help you get any job, big or small, done right. Homeowners and contractors find the equipment they want and the advice they need. Throw a party with Taylor Rental. Don't trust your special event or party to anyone but our experienced event coordinators. From a small dinner to a major event, we rent tents, tables, chairs, china, dance floors, and much, much more. Rent the latest in new equipment. Rent from Taylor and rent with confidence.
Well, all the fun in basketball, not at the Bangor Auditorium this time of the year. There's some throughout Eastern Maine for Class A teams tonight, too, right here at Brewer High School. A minute 44 to go. Brewer 67, Mount Blue 65, and the game means something. Brewer needs to win to go to the tournament.
No question about it. Some big ball games all over the place. You know, big game at Presque Isle today for them. A big game down at Lawrence, with Coney and Lawrence, and Lawrence being victorious in that ball game, Prescott winning up there, just all kinds of big games, but none bigger for Mark Savage and the Brewer Witches than the remaining 1:44 of this one.
Well, hang on to your seat. Mike Hale, Tom Winston, and Tim Throckmorton with you as we come down the stretch with a minute 44 to go in the game. Brewer by a basket, and they have the ball. Possing down the middle, missing the layup. Wilkins pulls down the rebound for Mount Blue. 40 are in the paint. Dumps it off underneath. Justin Ireland was too far under. It's off Ireland out of bounds. It's Brewer ball.
Boy, both teams very fortunate. The last time down, Pawson has a great look on a great attempt on the drive. Can't make the bunny. This time, Mount Blue turns it over.
And I believe we're going to have another warning. This time it will go Mount Blue as Wilkins reached over the plane. So there's a warning. Next time it would be a technical foul. A little bit too over-anxious on defense. Mount Blue in a full-court man-to-man with a minute 30 to go. They trail by a basket to Brewer. It's anybody's game with a minute 30 to go.
Let's see if Brewer might try to send somebody long. They do. They're going to try to open it up.
Good defense. Just barely got it in and then knocked right back out of bounds by Jim Ross. And Mount Blue turning up the heat. Full-court pressure, and they're playing it well right now. 1 second went off the clock. Minute 29 to go. Into Leighton. Leighton trying to avoid the double team, needs some help. Gets it off to Pawson. Johnston, up court, Levitt. Levitt to the basket, hangs in the air. He scores the basket and he's fouled.
That might be the play of the game so far. A great play that time. King was coming down the weak side. Levitt decided to take it himself. He scores and he's going to the line.
Watch this.
Watch this coming down. Gets it on the right-hand side, goes to the hoop. He sees King if he needs him. Foul was called, hoop's good. He'll shoot a chance for a three-point play.
It was a tough shot. He had to change his shot a bit. He was hanging in the air, had to twist sideways to protect the ball. Kissed it off the glass, and the foul on Jeremy Bryant of Mount Blue, his fourth. 69-65 Brewer, a minute 20 to go. Levitt missing the foul shot. And it's picked up by Mount Blue. Jim Ross chases it down, and he'll bring it up. And now it's Ryan Fortier. Minute 5 to go. Brewer by 4. Timeout, Mount Blue. They want to talk it over. Down 4. We'll take a 30-second timeout ourselves and be right back at Brewer High School.
This is not just another pretty face. This is not just another pretty truck. And this is not just another commercial. It's the chance of a lifetime to own a tough Chevy truck, the longest lasting, most dependable truck on the road. Nobody sells more Chevy trucks than Bean and Conquest, and Bean and Conquest has never had more Chevy trucks in stock.
I'll put you into a new truck for less than anyone else. I am that guy who dares to deal, you know, at Bean and Conquest Chevrolet for your new Chevy truck.
Well, there's a minute 4 to go in this game. Brewer leading Mount Blue 69-65. When they played in Farmington earlier this year, it ended up Mount Blue 67, Brewer 64. So we're on about the same pace as that game. But Brewer is on top right now with a minute 4 to go.
I tell you, you can expect the pressure from Mount Blue down 4 with 104 remaining to be turned up and make this building a little bit hotter here in the last 104. Mark Savage, this might be the last 104 of his season. He's hoping not. He's hoping his team can hang on. I tell you, it's going to be the longest 104 of his season.
Well, Lawrence helped by beating Coney tonight. Now Brewer has a chance to do it for themselves to sneak into the tournament. Fortier open underneath. Fortier scores the basket. He's fouled. Big play by Mount Blue. They got their key man open underneath.
We've talked all night long about being allowed to catch the ball inside too easily, and Fortier got loose. No excuse for that as far as the Brewer defense is concerned. Just a defensive lapse, and now we have a chance for a three-point play.
Joe McLaughlin coming out of the game. Dustin Ireland is in for Mount Blue. We have 57 seconds to go. Brewer leads 69-67. 20 points for Ryan Fortier. Yeah. missing the foul shot. Wilkins with a rebound. Ties it at 69. Wilkins with the big board and the basket. We're tied up with 45 seconds to go. Brewer with the basketball. It's Pawson in the backcourt. Dribbles through the double team. Heads up play by Pawson. Leighton, foul line. Jump shot is good.
Big hoop, Jason Leighton.
Brewer leads 71-69 with 28 seconds to go. Mount Blue is Jeremy Bryant. Picked up by Pawson. Mount Blue calls a timeout. Let's take a look at that Brewer basket. Leighton.
Boy, Leighton has the eye. He's been a leader. Pulls up just inside the foul line and nothing but. Now, you talk about a crucial shot for Jason Leighton.
You don't mind having him taking that high percentage shot just across the foul line because that's a sweet spot for him. And he puts his team back on top, 71-69 with 23 seconds to go. And if you make the tournament this way, it's not anything. It's not sneaking in the back door. It's making a lot of noise coming in the back door.
You've got that, and I tell you, we mentioned it earlier. If you're Messalonsky, Bangor, Old Town, whoever's going to end up playing a Brewer, should they hang on and win this one, you don't want to play a team with the capability that a Brewer has in the first round of a tournament in the quarterfinal game. But Brewer has a lot of work to do. They're ahead two with 23 seconds left. Mount Blue has the basketball. Interesting, Mike, here. If you're Mount Blue coach Jim Bessie, do you go for three and try to win it on the road? Strategy, interesting strategy here. Both teams in the double bonus. The alternate possession right now belongs with Mount Blue.
All right, 23 seconds to go. Mount Blue with the basketball. They trail Brewer 71-69. It's Bryant down in the corner to Ross. In the paint, 40 or to the hoop. It's blocked by Lovett. Loose ball and a foul on nobody. Out of bounds.
Out of bounds, going to go to Mount Blue.
So Mount Blue will have a possession with 13 seconds to go. They have down by two. Let's see what they do. Fortier with the ball. Nearly stolen by Lovett. It's out of bounds. It's off the foot of Fortier. Lovett knocked it loose. Went off Fortier's foot. Brewer gets the basketball with 10 seconds to go. And a two-point lead. They call a timeout. Let's see that big block a moment ago, Tom.
Great play inside. Levitt's going to get the block. Ball's going to be knocked out of bounds eventually. And then on the next possession, Lovett again comes up with a huge play defensively and gets it knocked off the Mount Blue offensive player. And just an unbelievable sequence as far as Troy Lovett is concerned.
Two key defensive plays which could make the difference in this game with 10 seconds showing on the clock. The team's over on the sideline. Mark Savage in the huddle with the Brewer Witches. And his team up by a basket. 10 seconds to go in a must-win game.
I tell you what, Mark Savage is earning his money tonight. He, you know, it's just a tough situation. A lot of pressure on Coach Savage. He's got his team ready, and they're playing a great ball game. 10 seconds remaining. You've got to make sure, as Coach Bessie looks on, you've got to make sure if you're Brewer, number one, that you get the ball inbounds. If you can't get it in, you call timeout. Number two, you take care of it and protect the basketball. Try to seal it at the foul line because you know Mount Blue is going to foul.
Mount Blue needs the basketball. They're down by two with 10 seconds to go. They'll let it come into bounds to Lovett in the backcourt. And there's the foul. It's going to be an intentional foul on Jeremy Bryant. And that means two foul shots for Leighton and a Brewer possession. That could mean the game.
I tell you what, and Jim Bessie doesn't like this, but that is a great gutsy call by John Shoppy in that situation. Really, the intent was clearly there. And as the rule book reads, anything in the last 2 minutes like that is automatic. Two shots in the basketball, intentional foul.
Been some big plays down at the stretch, and there is another one. And you got the man on the foul line you want to have there, too. And Mr. Leighton, Jason Leighton.
30 seconds to replace a disqualified player as, excuse me, fouling out for Mount Blue that time was Jeremy Bryant, their starting point guard. Both teams using it at their respective huddles. And just listen to the fans. Listen, this place ready to erupt.
Mount Blue now opts to call the timeout. 6 seconds to go. Let's watch the coaches react to the foul call a moment ago. I guess you can tell which coach is which in that case.
Brewer coaches Mark Savage and Becky Boover certainly agreeing with that call. I think it was a good call. The intent was clearly there.
Brewer's been inconsistent all year, but it seems like when it comes down to the big game, they put it together and show what they're really made out of. They've struggled. They're not supposed to be 9-9. They're supposed to be much better and a little higher up, much like last year. But when the big game comes on, they've been showing us some fireworks.
And I'll tell you what, I also wouldn't want to be the team that has to play Mount Blue in the tournament. This is a good basketball team.
Yeah, we said Mount Blue right in the middle of the pack there at number six. Could be a sleeper, too. Just kind of waiting to pounce on the top three teams. So it's going to be a great tournament this year. You can see all the makings of it on the regular season games we've had as Jason Leighton with 21 big points on the night shoots two foul shots. Brewer leads by three. This next one's a big shot.
Certainly is. If he makes this one, it will make a two-possession game for Mount Blue. And the thing that you got to like is Brewer will also have the basketball here.
Leighton gets it. Brewer has the ball and probably the win with 6 seconds to go. Wow.
I'll tell you, with what happened in this matchup last year in the tournament, let's see if Brewer's looking for timeout. They do want timeout. 6 seconds remaining, 73-69. Brewer by four with a basketball. We're back in 30 seconds.
GMC means more than the only company that builds only trucks.
GMC means you get more class for no more cash.
So GMC means lots more truck for no more bucks.
And GMC's not just better looking. GMC builds a better truck from the frame rail up for often less money than Ford.
But there's still only one way to know why GMC is Maine's most popular truck.
One test drive today and you too may say it's GMC work truck to me.
There's 6 seconds to go in this game. Brewer with the lead, and they also have the basketball, so they're in real good position right now. The Brewer, which a moment ago was running up and down the sideline, and they had the wave going on.
Denny almost got knocked over.
We had the wave at Brewer High School.
I tell you what, if we can plan to get a shot of this crowd, if Brewer hangs on for this victory, this place is going to go nuts.
They want to go to the tournament, and they could be 6 seconds away. Nearly stolen, saved inbounds nicely by Wilkins. Shot underneath is good. The time will run out. Scott Myrick made the basket, but Brewer wins it 73-71. Brewer fans excited knowing. The Brewer band joining in with the cheering and enjoying that celebration. Tough loss for Mount Blue, but they're in the tournament. Brewer's now in the tournament. And the two coaches who battled back and forth saying what a game and discussing a couple of things that might have happened. Coach Savage on the right, Coach Bessie on the left.
What a great shot. Interscholastic athletics at its best tonight with this Brewer-Mount Blue game. The coaches getting together after the game, showing their mutual respect for each other. They know they're both going to be there now, and it should be an interesting situation for both Brewer and Mount Blue come tournament time early in March.
So they wrap up their seasons. Brewer 9-9, Mount Blue 12-6. And let's go down to Tim Throckmorton with a couple of the players from Brewer.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. Troy Levitt, you had a great fourth quarter. The last 120 was terrific. You kind of took over offensively. Drive into the hole with 120 left, no doubt about that one.
Yeah, I had to make it. We were just barely ahead, and I just had to make that shot.
You know, I didn't realize you could really jump out of the gym. That block with about 30 seconds left was incredible.
Yeah, it was luck. I just happened to time it right, and he shot it, and I jumped as high as I could and got a piece of it.
How do you feel right now?
I feel good. I think we're in the tournament. That's all I wanted.
Good job, Troy. Congratulations. And Jason Leighton, fourth quarter, it looked like defensive pressure really picked up a notch.
Yeah. I think the fourth quarter, everybody, sucked it up here and got it going.
Hit a couple of key shots yourself. you looked great, so smooth in the fourth quarter, and everybody looked so confident with a big basket right there, and of course the foul shots at the tail end of the game. Boy, it looks so easy.
It's not easy. You got to work hard to get here. And I knew I had to step it up a notch, because if not, this would have been my last game here. So, you know, I stepped up. I thought I did good.
You know Lawrence won.
Yeah.
And so you think you're in.
God, I hope so.
It's got to be a sweet feeling right now.
Yeah, it is.
Let's get Coach over here. Mark, grab Coach over there, Jason, if you can. One more errand for Jason Leighton. Mark's signing autographs over there now and giving away tournament tickets. It's got to be a sweet feeling right now, knowing Lawrence won and with this big win.
Oh, it's great, Tim. It's just wonderful. We've had a tough year. The kids have battled back, and they showed some real character tonight. There was no give up tonight, and that's we fought through that this year.
You know, Mark, you should hire us to come over. You have won more big games on Channel 5.
Well, that was mentioned by another coach before the game started, that we got on TV a little bit, and I don't know, these guys like showtime, I guess.
Now it's just a matter of waiting for the final heel points, but it looks good right now. We'll have to wait till, another couple of days to make sure, but congratulations on this
Thank
big one.
Thank you very much, Tim. Thank you. It's great. It's great.
Super job.
Thank
you. Let's go now. Let's take a break. We'll be back to Brewer High School gym and talk more about this big win right after this.
Sounds easy, and Home Vision Videos, everything's on sale. This Saturday, starting at 9 a.m., there are so many new releases coming in March, we don't know where we're going to put them. So here's your chance to build your library and save big. Hot new releases, video games, kid bits, everything. Everything on our rental shelves is on sale. We've got to make room for the new releases coming in March. That means you get the savings during the Everything's on Sale at all Front Row, Sounds Easy, and Home Vision Video stores. Saturday, starting at 9 a.m.
Who's calling? Could it be the realtor? Hey, maybe she's got somebody interested in the house. Ooh, maybe she's got an offer.
Hello?
If you missed the call, press star 69. 9X will return the call for you.
They want to see the house? Great. In an hour?
When you're not in time, star 69. It's on your phone right now. Another way 9X makes your life simpler.
If you're looking for an affordable sports utility, just say, "Gimme a Jimmy."
Jimmy is the sports utility from GMC.
Only the company that builds only trucks has the strength of experience to build you more truck for less bucks. So you get a great sports utility for often less money than Explorer or Cherokee.
That's only one reason why GMC is Maine's fastest growing pure truck family. One test drive today and you too may say,
"Gimme a Jimmy" from GMC.
There's been a lot of excitement at the Bangor Auditorium this week with the tournament going on there, but it was a tournament atmosphere tonight at Brewer High School as the Witches pulled out a big win over Mount Blue, 73-71, and a well-balanced attack on both sides tonight.
The thing that Brewer did in the second half, as you can see in the stats, they controlled 40. He had 14 at halftime, only 6 in the second half for 20 points. Wilkins with 14, Bryant with 13 for Mount Blue, Leighton with 23, and none bigger than the last one he had, no question. Levitt with 13, and a great job by Levitt, especially in the second half. And Johnston also, another solid game for Mike Johnston with 12 points.
Leighton, who played a great game and hit some key shots, as we see Jason here.
That might be the biggest basket that he's hit in a while right there. Just a key hoop and doing a great job again for the Brewer Witches.
It was close all the way. Mount Blue led 19-16 after one at the half. It was tied at 39 at the end of three. It was Mount Blue up 59-56. So this one was a heated game all the way through. It was a lot of fun. I've seen so many great games here at Brewer High School over the years, covering both radio and television, and this is another one to put in the books tonight, that's for certain.
Just a fantastic job. And maybe Brewer High School will hire Channel 5 to come back here for their regular season games next year.
Seem to bring them good luck. The Brewer Witches finish at 9-9. Mount Blue at 12-6. The final again, Brewer 73, Mount Blue 71. Mike Hale for Tom Winston, Tim Throckmorton, John Boyer, and the production crew. Good night from Brewer High School. Thanks for watching.